Good afternoon. This week for the third course we have past tense of the verb be, regulars and irregular verbs, and the activities oral practice page 82. Listen, read and repeat. 1. Cristóbal Columbus wasn't Spanish, he was Italian. 2. Michael Jackson wasn't fat, he was thin. 3. Marilyn Monroe wasn't a singer, she was an actress. 4. Nelson Mandela wasn't Bosnian, he was South African. 5. Mahatma Gandhi wasn't a president, he was a religious leader. 6. Mother Teresa wasn't a doctor, she was a missionary. 7. Napoleon wasn't fat, he was average weight. 8. Adolf Hitler wasn't born in Germany, he was born in Austria. 9. Joan of Arc wasn't Italian, she was a French heroine. Una vez que terminan el oral practice, comenzamos a completar el libro. Dice, answer the questions according page 82. Was Joan of Arc Italian? No, she wasn't, she was French. Entonces lo que hay que hacer es primero completar con el yes or no. A continuación va a llevar si es yes, was o were, y si es no, wasn't o weren't. Y luego en otra oración nueva ponen la oración que corresponde a la última que ustedes van a tener aquí. Ya sea yes o no. Y yes, y repiten lo que está aquí. Por ejemplo, was Marilyn Monroe an actress? Entonces nos fijamos aquí. Marilyn Monroe wasn't a singer, she was an actress. Entonces, yes, she was. Y después, Marilyn Monroe was an actress. Podemos poner entonces, o she was an actress igual. Siguiente ejercicio. Write a paragraph with the answer from page 82. O sea, con todas las respuestas que ustedes tengan aquí, vamos a hacer una oración. Lo que podemos hacer es copiar todo lo que está acá. Christopher Columbus wasn't Spanish, he was Italian. Michael Jackson wasn't fat, he was thin. Entonces hay que ir copiando eso aquí y hacer un párrafo. Es copiar nada más las oraciones y hacer un párrafo. Por eso no lo estoy haciendo. Match the question with the answers. Ustedes tienen que escribir aquí el número de respuesta, digamos, el número de pregunta que corresponde a la respuesta. Who was Marshall José Félix Estigarribia? Y podemos ver aquí, he was a Paraguayan hero and president of the republic, or he was Paraguayan novelist, or he was a Jesus priest, or he was a first native Guarani, he was the first constitutional president, he was a great Guarani chief. I think it's the first one, he was the Paraguayan hero. Who was Carlos Antonio López? He was the first constitutional president of Republic of Paraguay. Who was Lambaré? Lambaré was a great Guarani chief who rebelled against the Spanish. Who was Augusto Roa Basto? He was a Paraguayan novelist and short story writer. Who was Roque González de Santa Cruz? He was a Jesuit priest and a missionary among the Guarani people. And who was India Juliana? She was the first native Guarani who wanted to revolt because she was sexually subjugated by the European conquerors. Write the missing questions to this answer. We have the answers. I was at the movies yesterday afternoon. Where were you yesterday afternoon? Were you at the shopping mall? Or who were with you or who was with you? Oral practice, page 85. 1. I ate 2 bananas and milk for breakfast. 2. I went to the gym to practice with weights. 3. I wrote a love letter to my love. 4. I read a book called How to Get Rich. 5. I did all my homework all day long. 6. I made 2 cakes for my mother. 7. I rode my bike in the park. 8. I slept only 2 hours because I dance a lot. 9. I sold my car because I need a good notebook. Change the sentences from page 85 from I to she, to he or she. I ate 2 bananas and milk for breakfast. Entonces, cambiamos. I went to the gym. She went to the gym. En el caso de Pamela es she. Janet is she. She wrote a love letter. Henry is he. He read a book. Isabel is she. She did all her homework. En este caso hay que cambiar el my por her. Billy made 2 cakes for his mother. En este caso cambiamos por her y en este caso por his. Fiona, she rode her bike. She spent only 2 hours because she danced a lot. Robert, he sold a car because he need a good notebook. Who read a book? Henry read a book called Mary Slept. Bueno, eso es de acuerdo a la respuesta que tenemos aquí. Pregunta, who wrote a love letter? Janet wrote a love letter to his love. Entonces, eso es lo que se escribe aquí. Y creo que me falta. A ver, un poco 86 y la 87 me falta. Me falta una página. Falta la 87 aquí. Vamos a insertarla raudamente. Aquí. Vamos a insertar la página 87. No se encuentra. ¿Cómo puede ser posible que no se encuentre la página 87 si está allí? Aquí está. Y en la página 87 tenemos la lista de verbos regulares e irregulares. Esta es la lista para que ustedes puedan aprender. Y aquí tenemos la forma afirmativa, negativa, interrogativa de del verbo de los verbos regulares y los irregulares abajo. Espero que este video les sea útil. No complete nada para que ustedes puedan completar porque se plaguean de que yo completo todo. Entonces, para que ustedes tengan la oportunidad de completar. Cualquier cosa, nos encontramos en este link en cualquiera de estos 2 días. See you.